Now I want to talk about a reaction that's so similar to halogenation that a lot of people get it confused with halogenation. It's just a little bit different because in this case, we're going to be adding a halogen in the presence of water to a double bond. And this reaction is going to be called a halohydrin formation, okay? So let's go ahead and get started. Basically, the general reaction is that I still have my double bond, I still have my diatomic halogen. The only difference is that I'm running this reaction in the presence of water instead of an inert solvent. I actually have water present. What that means is that the water is going to wind up interacting, and my end product is going to give me an alcohol on one side and a halogen on the other. This molecule right here is called, as a functional group, it's called a halohydrin. Okay? So let's go ahead and talk about the actual mechanism. The intermediate is once again going to be a bridged ion, just like before. The stereochemistry is going to be anti, just like before, because anytime you're opening up a three-membered ring, you're going to wind up getting anti-products. And my product is going to be a halohydrin. Okay? Are there going to be rearrangements? Nope. Okay, so no rearrangements because there's no carbonyl. I said that completely wrong. No carbocation. And then finally, this actually will have Markovnikov regiochemistry because now I am adding two different things. So now I do have to be aware of which one goes on the Markovnikov side and which one goes on the anti-Markovnikov side. But overall, we would say this is a Markovnikov reaction because it's driven by the stability of the intermediate. Okay?